Hi, let's talk about the muscles of respiration. As you may recall, pressure times volume equals a constant as per Boyle's law. Therefore, pressure is inversely proportional to volume. The volume of the pleural cavities within the thoracic cavity determines the pressure and therefore determines the movement of gases in and out of the lungs. So, as volume increases, pressure decreases and air can run into the lungs. As volume decreases, pressure increases, then air will leave the lungs. So whatever the muscles can do to act upon the volume of the thoracic cavity, they can affect pressure and therefore affect ventilation. So the major muscle that's involved in the movement of air in and out of the lungs or the process of ventilation is the diaphragm. We can see the diaphragm here sitting between the thoracic cavity and the abdominal pelvic cavity. And as the diaphragm contracts, it's displaced inferiorly. And so as the diaphragm contracts, it increases the volume and decreases the pressure within the thoracic cavity for inhalation. Now, the diaphragm is aided by many other muscles, far too many to discuss as part of this particular station, but there are two sets of intercostal muscles that you should see while you're here. There are external intercostal muscles. These are found in the intercostal space, which is the space between the ribs. And external intercostal muscles, if we look, have their fibers running obliquely with the trailing edge going more medially. So if you think about, you know, putting your hands, these are the worst hands ever, in your pockets, those would be running in the same direction as the fibers of the external intercostal muscles. The external intercostal muscles are going to pull the ribs outward and upward. By pulling the ribs outward and upward, this is going to increase the volume of the thoracic cavity, decrease pressure, and therefore be helpful for the process of forced inhalation. Now we can see some of the internal intercostal muscles here, but if we strip away the external intercostal muscles, let's look over here. So here's the intercostal space, and I'll go a little wide on the rib so that we can see that the external intercostal muscles have been removed. We can see the fibers of the internal intercostal muscles have their leading edges more laterally. So we can contrast that with the external intercostal muscles where they're moving medially. Anyhow, when the internal intercostal muscles contract, they pull the ribs downward and inward. By pulling the ribs downward and inward, that's going to decrease volume and increase pressure. Therefore, internal intercostal muscles are going to help with the process of forceful exhalation. There are a number of other muscles which can act upon the total volume of the thoracic cavity. So for instance, the abdominal muscles, by exerting pressure on the abdomen, can affect tension of the diaphragm and therefore affect pressure of the thoracic cavity. Pectoralis minor, serratus anterior, all attached to ribs and can pull them. The anterior, middle, and scalene muscles, as well as sternocleidomastoid, are also going to insert on ribs 1 and 2, as well as the manubrium of the sternum, respectively. So therefore, they can affect inhalation and exhalation. But the major muscles to really see as part of this station are the diaphragm,
and the external and internal intercostal muscles. Thank you very much for your time.